Dining etiquettes. Etiquettes affect almost every aspect of dining. Table manners are the rules of etiquette used while eating, which may also include the appropriate use of utensils. Different cultures observe different rules for table manners. Each family or group set its own standard for how strictly these rules are to be enforced. Etiquettes are visible signals of the state of our manners and therefore are essential to professional success. The point of etiquette rule is to make you feel comfortable, not uncomfortable. Points to learn for dining etiquettes are: meaning of dining etiquettes, table setting, arrangement of napkins, silverware and dinnerware, postures and elbow, when you arrive at the table, serving food, using of forks and knife when you have finished, general tips, specific food etiquette. What do you understand by the term dining etiquette? Dining etiquette is an area of etiquette which pertains to dining, whether at home or out in restaurant. Etiquette in general is a series of suggestions and rules of behavior which are designed to ensure that people behave consistently and within the norms of politeness. Table manners are noticeable sign that you are polished and knowledgeable professional. You never get second chance to make a first impression. And in this fast food era, many people have forgotten or were never taught the essential of dining etiquette. Table manners play a significant part in making a favorable impression. Meals can be used to examine your behavior in social setting to see how you conduct yourself, particularly if the job for which you are interviewing requires a certain standard of conduct with clients and superiors. Now, let us understand the concept of table settings. Table settings refers to the way to set a table with tableware, such as eating utensils for serving and eating. The arrangement for a single dinner is called a place setting. Keep solids to the left and liquids to the right. Then pick up a silverware from the outside in and towards your tip plate and put napkin on your lap as soon as host does. Napkin remain on your lap until completion of meal. What is formal table setting? The one rule for a formal table is for everything need to be geometrically spaced. The centerpiece at the exact center, the place setting at equal distances, the utensils balance, and beyond these placement, you can vary flower arrangement and decoration as you like. For better understanding, look at the picture of formal table setting. For a formal setting, the napkin is placed on the center plate or charger, but it can also be placed to the left of the plate under the forks or to the left of the forks. To the right of the plate from the left are the dinner knife and soup spoon. Now, we will go through the step-by-step instruction of how to use napkin. First, we'll go through what are the steps need to follow in a restaurant. As soon as you are seated, remove the napkin from your place setting, unfold it and put it on your lap and do not shake it open. The napkin rests on the lap till the end of meal. Do not clean the cutlery or wipe your face with the napkin and never use it to wipe your nose. If you excuse yourself from the table, loosely fold the napkin and place it to the left or right of your plate and do not refold your napkin and never place your napkin on your chair. At the end of the meal, leave the napkin semi-folded at the left side of the place setting. It should not be twisted and nor it should be folded. Following are the steps at a formal dinner or a private party. Now, let us see what are the following steps at a formal dinner or private party that need to be followed. The meal starts when the host or hostesses unfold his or her napkin. This is your signal to do the same. Put the napkin on your lap, completely unfold it lengthwise. If it is a large dinner napkin, do not shake it open. The napkin resets on the lap until the end of the meal. Put the napkin in loose folds to the left of your plate. The host will signal the end of the meal by placing his or her napkin on the table. Once the meal is over, you too should put your napkin neatly on the table to the left of your dinner plate and do not refold your napkin either. What is the proper use of silverware and dinnerware? A formal table setting can appear overwhelming. Do not panic. Remember, eat to your left and drink to your right. Any food dish to the left is yours and any glass to the right is yours. Starting with the knife, fork or spoon that is the farthest from your plate, work your way in using one utensil for each course. The salad fork is one your outermost left and followed by your dinner fork. Your spoon is on your outermost right, followed by your beverage spoon, salad knife and dinner knife. Your dessert spoon and fork are above your plate or brought out with dessert. If you remember the rule to work from the outside in, then you will be fine. Postures and elbow. Proper dining etiquette is also required good posture when approaching the table. Pulling out your or someone else's chair when seated and conversing and eating. Posture. You need not to sit stiff at the dinner table. Bend your shoulders over the plate is a definite do not. Likewise, slouching back in your chair is bad table manners when eating with others. Elbows. As for not putting your elbow on the table, this drummed into us a taboo applies only when you are actually eating. To avoid crowding one's dinner partner during a meal, the elbow remains close to the body and of the table. When you arrive at the tables, some steps need to be undertaken that don't place any bags, purses, or sunglasses, cell phones on the table. When everyone is seated, gently unfold your napkin and place it on your lap. Fold it in half with the fold towards your waist. Keep utensils in the same order they appear on the table. Do not rearrange utensils to accommodate yourself if you are left-handed. Wait for all parties to arrive before beginning any part of the meal. How to serve food. Here are some steps guiding you on how to serve and pass food. Pass food the right. Transfer dip to your plate. Plates are served on the left. Dishes removed from the right. Pass the salt and pepper together. How to use forks and knife. Eating utensils etiquette. Describe the correct etiquette with the use of eating utensils. The rules that specify how knife, fork must be used have evolved along with the form of utensils themselves. When you are using the fork and knife to cut your food, cut the food by holding the knife in the right hand and the fork in the left hand, with the fork tines piercing the food to secure it on the plate. Cut a few bite-sized pieces of food, then lay your knife across the top edge of your plate with the sharp edge of the blade facing in. Change your fork from your left to your right hand. If you are left-handed, keep your fork in your left hand and tines facing up. When you have finished food, what steps need to be taken? Do not push your plate away from you or stack them up. Leave plates and glasses where they are in the place setting. To indicate that you are done with the course, reset your fork and tines up and knife blade in with the handles resetting at 5 o'clock and tips pointing to 10 o'clock on your plate. Now, let us study what are the specific food etiquette. Berries. Generally eat berries with a spoon whether they have cream or not. Bread. Break slices of bread rolls and muffins in half or in small pieces, never larger than one bite. Butter each bite at a time. When the rolls are served in a basket, take one and always pass the basket to your right. Never tear your roll in half or into many pieces. Use your own butter knife and the butter on your plate. Buttering should be done on the plate. Oysters in the half shell and hold the shell with the left hand and lift the clam out using your oyster fork. Crab, shrimp and lobster cocktails. These are to be eaten with a cocktail fork. Fried fantail shrimp picked up by the tail and eaten with the fingers. Potatoes, if not already cut, cut across the top with a knife and open the potato wider with your fork and add butter or sour cream, salt and pepper, and you may eat the skin as you go along. Do not take the inside out and put the skin aside. Here are the important tips on dinner table etiquette that will help you through any formal or semi-formal lunch party or dinner party. Be punctual. If there is an necessary delay, contact your host. Keep up to date on current event in your industry so you can have appropriate conversation. Remember, The meal is a part of the interview. Pass food from the left to right. Always say please when you ask for something. Make sure to say thank you to your server and busboy. Never cut off a pass. Snag a roll out of the bread basket or take a shake of salt when it is an en route to someone else is a complete no. Never turn a wine glass upside down to decline wine. It is more courteous to let the wine be poured and not drawn attention. Otherwise, hold your hand over the wine glass to signal that you don't want any wine. Taste your food before flavoring it. Do not blow on your food to cool it off. If it is too hot to eat, take the hint and wait. Do not talk with your mouth full. Chew with your mouth closed. Cut only enough food for the next mouthful. Eat in small bites and eat slowly. At networking events, following steps need to be taken. First, make a target of meeting 5 new people in an hour. Second, keep one hand free to shake hands. Third, wait to eat until you are done meeting people. Fourth, when approaching to a small group, introduce yourself, include new arrivals in the conversation. In this session, we have covered the important points of dining etiquettes. You can use these skills in everything from business meeting to networking events. Thank you.